हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू आवर प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ असेंबली लैंग्वेज प्रोग्रामिंग इन 8085 माइक्रो प्रोसेसर। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ टू 8-बिट नंबर्स इन 8085 माइक्रो प्रोसेसर। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद दिस टॉपिक। वी नो इन असेंबली लैंग्वेज प्रोग्रामिंग वी हैव इंस्ट्रक्शन फॉर एड एंड फॉर सब्ट्रैक्शन, बट देर इज नो स्पेसिफिक इंस्ट्रक्शन फॉर परफॉर्मिंग मल्टीप्लीकेशन और डिविजन ऑफ टू नंबर्स। सो हाउ वी विल डू द मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन? वी विल यूज एड एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन इंस्ट्रक्शन मल्टीपल टाइम्स सो दैट इट वर्क एज मल्टीप्लीकेशन। सी, इफ वी हैव टू नंबर्स, लेट्स से 0 4 हेक्स एंड 0 3 हेक्स, एंड वी नीड टू मल्टीप्लाई बोथ ऑफ दीज नंबर्स। सो इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई देम इन डेसिमल वी विल गेट 12, बट इन हेक्साडेसिमल दिस विल गिव अस 0 C hex। सो हाउ वी विल गेट दिस रिजल्ट आफ्टर मल्टीप्लाइंग देम? वी कैन एड 0 4 हेक्स विथ इटसेल्फ 3 टाइम्स। इफ यू डू सो, 0 4 + 0 4 + 0 4, हियर वी हैव एडेड इट 3 टाइम्स, राइट? दिस इज 1, दिस इज 2 एंड दिस इज 3, एंड दिस विल गिव अस 12 हेक्स। सो इन मल्टीप्लीकेशन इफ अ नंबर इज एडेड विथ इटसेल्फ this number of times, then we will get the result of multiplication. Just take another example, 0 6 into 0 3 hex. So if we add 6 three times, what we will get? 6 + 6 + 6 is equals to 18, but in hexadecimal this will be equals to 12 hex. So I hope this is clear. By repetitive addition we can get the result of multiplication. Now let's write the assembly language program for multiplication. So in the beginning we will input both the numbers that are to be multiplied. So LXI H comma C050 hex. Okay, I'm taking input from C050 hex address. So this will be the first data, and we are storing this data into the register B. Okay. So if you take this example, so here the register B will be containing the first data, that is 0 4 hex, and then we are initializing the content of accumulator with 0 0 hex, just for safety, so that the accumulator does not contain any garbage value. Now we also need to initialize another register, let's say D, with 0 0 hex. Why so? This register will be storing all the carry that has been generated while performing the addition, that means multiplication. So D register will be holding the content of the carry part. So we will input the second data from next memory location, that is C051 hex. So here we will be having 0 3 hex, and we are moving this into the register C. So now the C register contains the data 0 3 hex. Alright, so till now we have both the data stored in the register B and the register C. Now how we will add them? So see here, in the first we are having the content of accumulator as 0 0 hex, and the B register is containing 0 4 hex, and C register is containing 0 3 hex, right? Now we will add the content of B with the accumulator. So the accumulator will be containing what? 0 4 hex. Why? 0 0 + 0 4 = 0 4 hex. And simultaneously we will decrease the content of the register C. Why? Because we have added the content of B for the first time, so we are also decrementing it. Now again we will add the content of B with the register A, so it will be containing 0 8 hex. And again, simultaneously, the content of register C will be decremented to 1. Okay, then in the next part, 0 8 + 0 4 hex. This will give us 12 in decimal, but in hexadecimal, we will be having 0 C hex. And simultaneously, the content of C register will be decreased to 0 0 hex. So now you can see the register C is containing 0 0 hex. That means when the content of C register will become 0 0 hex, at that time the multiplication is completed. Okay, so this will be the general idea. Now implement it in the air. So after having both the data in register B and C, what we will add the content of accumulator with the content of register B. So add B, right? So now the accumulator will be containing this data, and here we also need to check the carry that is generated or not. So for that we will be using JNC instruction. That means if a carry is generated in the content of accumulator while adding the content of B register with 8, and if a carry is generated, then we need to increment the content of register D that is being initialized here to 00 hex. So if a carry is generated, D will be containing 01 hex, and if a carry is not generated, then this loop will jump to this place. And so if a carry is not generated, then after adding, what we need to do, we need to decrease the content of register C, right? So we will perform DCRC. So this will be the process, and this process is repeated how many times? We will check the content of the register C all the times. So after decrementing it here, we will be having JNZ instruction. Okay, let's say loop 2. So JNZ instruction, that means jump if no zero is occurring. Always remember, these jump instructions are being executed depending on the content of the register that is being used in the previous instruction. So the previous instruction, here the content is C register. So the content of C register will be checked if it is zero or not. If it is zero, then what it will mean? It will mean that the multiplication process is completed, right? So in that case, we will store the results. But when a zero is not been encountered, that means when C is 02 hex or 01 hex, then in that case, we again need to perform the addition, right? So this loop will jump to this location. See here, add B. That means after decrementing it, we again need to add the data. So this will be the location of loop 2. Okay, and this process will be repeated until the content of C register becomes 00 hex. So when it will be 00 hex, the next statements will be executed. So what will be the next statements? Now, as the multiplication is completed, we need to store the results, both the carry part and the result part. So here, as the result is stored in the accumulator, right? We are adding all the data and storing it in the accumulator. So we will store the content of accumulator in some memory location, let's say C052 hex. Okay, and now we also need to store the carry part. So the carry part is in D register. So first we will move the content of D register into the accumulator, and then we will store this result in C053X and then halt. Okay, now if you see the content of memory, then in C050X we will be having the first input, that is, let's say in this case we will be having 06X here. Then in C051X we will be having the second operand, that is 03X. Then in C052X, see here, we are storing the result part. So 6 into 3 is equals to 12 hex in hexadecimal. So it will be having 12 hex. And in C053 hex, we are storing the carry part. Here, there is no carry generated. Okay, so it will be storing 00 hex. So this is the output and this is the input. Okay. So I hope this process is clear for you. In the next video, we will see the division of two 8-bit numbers in 8085. So see you in the next video. Thank you.